Good morning. Welcome you to Pahaka Lutheran Church. It is the 14th Sunday after Pentecost, Sunday, September 6th. I have joyous news for you. Come September 20th, which is the third Sunday of the month, we will be reconvening for worship. There are going to be some really stringent rules to follow, including everybody coming in will have to be masked. We will practice social distancing, but we're going to try and see if we can come back as a community. Because we know that we're not going to be able to accommodate everybody who might want to be able to worship here in church, we're also going to open the basement up with the interior television. So there will be space for you either up or downstairs. We're excited about trying. We need your cooperation in order to pull it off. But please, please know that this is something that we've all been looking forward to. We've missed you. And so we're asking that you pray for us as we begin to start this process of coming back together as a church family in the house of God. Our service this morning comes from the Lutheran Book of Worship. It is the service of communion. And we begin with a brief order for confession and forgiveness. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us truly rejoice and be glad in it. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Most merciful God, we confess
that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves.
We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved
our neighbors as ourselves.
For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name.
Amen.
In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for you, and for his sake God forgives you all your sins. To those who believe in Jesus Christ, he gives the power to become the children of God, and bestows on them the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our entrance hymn is Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee.
Joyful, joyful, we adore thee, God of glory. Praising thee, their Son above.
our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. Almighty and eternal God, you know our problems and our weaknesses better than we ourselves. In your love and by your power, help us in our confusion, and in spite of our weakness, make us firm in the faith. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. The first lesson is from the 33rd chapter of Ezekiel. So you, mortal, I have made a sentinel for the house of Israel. Whenever you hear a word from my mouth, you shall give them warning from me. If I say to the wicked, O wicked ones, you shall surely die, and you do not speak to warn the wicked to turn from their ways, The wicked shall die in their iniquity, but their blood I will require at your hand. But if you warn the wicked to turn from their ways, and they do not turn from their ways, the wicked shall die in their iniquity, but you will have saved your life. Now you, mortal, say to the house of Israel, thus you have said, our transgressions and our sins weigh upon us, and we waste away because of them. How then can we live? Say to them, as I live, says the Lord God, I have no pleasure in the depth of the wicked, but that the wicked turn from their ways and live. Turn back from your evil ways, for why will you die, O house of Israel? The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. We will read the psalm responsibly. Teach me, O Lord, the way of your statutes, and I shall keep it to the end. Give me understanding, and I shall keep your law. I shall keep it with all my heart. Make me go in the path of your commandments, for that is my desire. Incline my heart to your decrees and not to unjust gain. Turn my eyes from watching what is worthless. Give me life in your ways.
Fulfill your promise to your servant, which you make to those who fear you.
Turn away the reproach which I dread, because your judgments are good.
Behold, I long for your commandments, and your righteousness preserve my life.
The second lesson is from the 13th chapter of Romans. Owe no one anything except to love one another. For the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. The commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not murder, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and any other commandment are summed up in this word. Love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no wrong to a neighbor. Therefore, love is fulfilling of the law. Besides this, you know what time it is, how it is now the moment for you to wake from sleep. For salvation is nearer to us now than when we became believers. The night is far gone, the day is near. Let us then lay aside the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Let us live honorably as in the day, not in revealing drunkenness, not in debauchery, not in not in quarreling and jealousy. Instead, put on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision the flesh to gratify its desires. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Matthew, the 18th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the disciples, if another member of the church sins against you, go and point out the fault when the two of you are alone. If the member listens to you, you have regained that one. But if you are not listened to, take one or two others along with you, so that every word may be confirmed by the evidence of two or three witnesses. If the member refuses to listen to them, tell it to the church. And if the offender refuses to listen even to the church, let such a one be to you as a Gentile and a tax collector. Truly I tell you, whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loose in heaven. Again, truly I tell you, if two of you agree on earth about anything you ask, it will be done for you by my Father in heaven. For where two or three are gathered in my name, I am there among them. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
And now, O Lord, let the words of my mouth and let the meditation of all of our hearts be always acceptable in your sight. Dear God, you are our strength and our redeemer. Amen.
Amen.
So I'm old. I'm old enough to remember in the old days when you used to buy a box of cereal and there was a prize hidden down inside the box. And no matter how many times my parents would say, now you eat that whole box, you wait till the box is empty and then you can have the prize, they wouldn't be out of the room 5 minutes when we start digging down in that box trying to find the prize. Because after all, who cared about the cereal? It never occurred to us that the prize might be a little dinky, something plastic that you could probably have bought at the store for a nickel, but it was in there. There was a prize to be had. And down we went, elbows deep into the box, trying to find it. Here in this gospel, we don't have to go elbows deep to find the prize. The prize is right here at the end of the gospel. Where two or three are gathered together in my name, I will be in the midst of them. But where two of you agree on anything, my Father will grant it to you. That's the prize of this gospel. Hang on to it. Because before we get to the prize, before we start digging down to our elbows, there are some things that we're supposed to do. It's hard to say this in 2020 when nobody gets along with anybody and everybody's yelling their point of view at each other. And if they're not doing it in person because of COVID, well, we have social media for that. And Lord knows we can put all kinds of stuff on there that we think, ha-ha, how clever that is. Until somebody we love reads it and says, what are you talking about? Why do you have that on there? And so it goes. And we may disagree with each other, but we have no idea how to start a conversation that says, why would you put that up there? Do you really believe that? Is this really who you've become? And in 2020, I don't know that we know who we've become. And I certainly know that because we're not seeing each other every single week in church, we're not able to hold each other accountable the way that we should to the gospel that we're supposed to be living our lives by. And so instead of us being tightly bound to Scripture, we become loosely bound in how we live our Christian witness. And being loosely bound on earth means that things are not binding us tightly to heaven. God says whatever we loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. Whatever we bind together on earth will be bound in heaven. And so if our bonds are loose on earth, then our relationship with heaven is going to be loosely bound as well. So what does that mean to us? It means that we have to go back to the drawing board before we can open that box of cereal and reach down for the prize. We don't even get in the store the way we are living our lives right now. confusion and frustration and trying to seek solutions and wondering if it's going to come from the seat of Washington or from some local politicians and trying to figure out all the rules, good Lord. The council and I sitting together this past week trying to figure out what the rules are so that we could even convene and come back into church. It took us longer in that discussion than we normally take to decide anything. What kind of mask? What kind of hand sanitizer? All of these different things just so that we can be in accord with the scripture that says we should be able to come together and talk to one another. We should be able to find accord in our Christian relationship. When we disagree, we should immediately come together to try and calm those disagreements and find a way to be back in accord with the gospel. How do we do that? For one thing, we need to honor the fact that we are a family in Christ. We are bound by the same rules. The rules come from the gospel, not from what we hear in the world. We are bound to find a point of agreement with one another. If it's one brother that we don't agree with, call him. Have the conversation. Don't be afraid and resistant to the fact that what we want together is peace and accord in Christ Jesus. And then the gospel says, well, if that doesn't work, get a couple of people together and go back and try again. Lord knows, I don't know that I've ever been in a situation where that's even happened. I'm not sure that I've ever seen the church do it. It's right here. The instructions are available to us. But I don't know that we've got the courage to try that. We're supposed to. And then there's mercy. If you go to a brother expecting to win the argument, you've already lost it. That bond has already become too loose to pull back together. If you go and my point of view is locked in my head and I'm going to say this and no matter what he says, I'm going to say this, there's no conversation to be had. There's an art to listening with mercy, to listening with compassion, to hearing where your brother or sister is coming from. And let me tell you this. In my 70-year journey on earth, I've had more people not listen to me than hear me. Particularly when you're walking around as a person of color, I don't even go there most of the time. And by the way, if any of you want to know what my political views are, I'm sorry. That's not happening either. Not because I don't have them, but because they're mine. And I'm not going to inflict them on you any more than I want you to inflict yours on me. We have other stuff to talk about. And most of it is bound right here in these scriptures. Use your Christian community to draw a lost brother in. We don't want the separation. We don't need the separation. What we need is the oneness of Christ's family. And we can have that. The scripture tells us we can. And we should desire it. It should be the deepest desire of our heart to be tightly bound in Christ Jesus and not loosely bound by what the world tells us we can and cannot do. I'm not going to say we're above it, but I am going to say that Jesus says to us, we are in the world, but not of the world. We are bound by a higher calling than that. And I am calling you to remind you, because it's not going to get better. The closer we get to November 1st, it's going to get more aggressive. The key is, are we going to get caught up in that? Are we going to allow it to break loose the bonds that Christ has called us together? Can we tie each other to the cross and hold fast to that? Or are we going to be loosely bound in what the world tells us we have to be? At the end of the day, we are called to a oneness in Christ that the world neither understands nor is committed to. We are called to be that beacon of light to the world that calls them into that oneness. We have the ties that bind. And if it binds us in earth, Christ says it binds us to heaven. And what's the prize at the end? Anything we ask where two of us agree, God's going to do it. What a powerful prayer tool that is. That's worth digging down in the box to your elbow, isn't it? Where two or three are gathered together, Jesus says, you're not digging in that box by yourself. I want you to have the prize. I'm going to be right there with you. There's power in the accord of Christians. There is strength in those bonds beyond anything the world can pull apart. We have a choice. We can be loosely bound. We can spend our lives loosely walking through life, not free, but not bound to the cross either. Just sort of floating our way through life, saying things we don't mean, being people we don't mean to be. Or we can bind ourselves tightly to one another with the cross of Christ as our foundation. And then what we can loose into the world is the freedom of the gospel and all of the wonders held there. We are not called to be loosely bound. We are called to bind each other together in the strength, in the mercy, in the understanding, and in the agreement of two or three together, and knowing that Jesus Christ will be with us always. The prize is there for the taking. All we have to do is dig in deep and know that Christ is digging in deep with us. Amen. Our hymn of the day is How Great Thou Art.
Consider all the works that my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
And now, let us reaffirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen.
Drawn together in the compassion of God, we pray for the church, the world, and all those in need. Unite your church, O God. Grant us the gifts of repentance and reconciliation. Bless the cooperative work of churches in this community. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Protect your creation, O God. Teach us ways that do not harm what you have entrusted to our care. Renew and enliven places suffering from drought, floods, storms, or pollution. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Turn nations and leaders from ways that lead to death. Shape new paths toward the peace and cooperation, teaching us to recognize one another as neighbors. Guide legislators, civil servants, judges, and police toward laws that protect the well-being of all. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Tend to all in need of your compassion. Hear the cries of those awaiting justice and those yearning for forgiveness. Give community to the lonely and neighbors to the outcast. Shelter all who are vulnerable in body, mind, or spirit. Especially we pray for Chris and for Carol. And we pray for Roxanne and her family. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Sustain us in our work, O God, and give work to those who need it. shape societies to ensure fair treatment for all who labor. Help us to love our neighbors in and through our work. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We remember with thanksgiving those who have died in faith. As you equip them, equip us with your protection and power, until with them we see your salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
All these things and whatever else you see that we need, we entrust to your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Please share with who's with you the sign of Christ's peace. Betrayed, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, gave thanks, and broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take it and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Whenever you do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is the cup of the new covenant poured out for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." And now, as our Savior Christ taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them and remember that Jesus Christ died for all sinners. For those of you at home, please remember to pick up your communion packet so that you can partake with us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us.
body of Christ broken for you. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. Strengthen us through this gift, in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace.
Amen.
Our closing hymn is Now Thank We All Our God.
With ever joyful hearts.
in peace. Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.